And today we are going to learn about populate one drop-down list based on another drop-down list selected value in ASP.NET MVC with the help of a jQuery. Let's open a project. Go to the file new and project. Let's select the web, ASP.NET web application. Web app drop down list. Select empty project MVC and click on OK. Open the Solution Explorer and right click the controller and add new controller. Select MVC controller empty and make a name home. First we'll add that one. Models name will be, you can write like this one will be the, what we are going to do that one first one drop down list will be the state and second one will be the city. Once you are going to select the state and belongs that that particular state, city will be display in the another drop down. So this one will be the state model. So what will be integer and state ID and second will be the name of the state, that this will be the string state name. And same way I am going to create one more kind model, that will be the city. This will be the city model. So here also it will be like a city ID. Second will be that with the reference, that is state ID, and third one will be the string. This one will be the string, that will be the city name. In the home controller I'm going to create that one, that I'm going to add that one dummy data for that state model and the city model. First I'm going to create that I enumerable of or make it a list of state model. State models. I'm going to create constructor of that controller. I'm going to initialize this one, this list of a state model. Same way, going to create list of city model. Now I'm going to create that object. of a city matter. Now I'm going to add a dummy data, some dummy data. State ID 1 and name is Karnataka. Then same way I'm going to add for city with the reference of this one dot add new city model city ID 1 state ID 1 and city name be Bangalore. So here I have added that one, that dummy data for some 6 record for that state and 12 record for city. So here you can see that one is auto number 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 12, and with the reference for the state ID and the reference of that one city. So here I am going to add, right click and add that one view. And from here I'm going to return that select list item. So this particular view I'm going to convert it to select list item. Select list of list item. So I'm going to create that object. So because this one is that is the list, so I am going to convert this particular that list of state models to the select list item. So how we can do that one, this just like this, make it bracket. From obj that list item here in, then select new select list item, and this one I'm going to convert into to list. And here there's so much properties is there, so we are going, I'm going to use that one text. This one text will be the obj dot state name, and one is the value, that is obj dot state ID. Okay, this two, this one need to convert into string, and this one I'm going to return into view. So go to the index here, that model, it will be the I enumerable of a select list item. So right here is state, and here that HTML helper dot, so a drop down list. First it will be the name of that list, so that particular name is that state, so I'm going to write state, and second will be the model, and third one make it null, and fourth one will be the HTML attributes. So just write an CSS drop down list. This one just run one time, so we'll check if data is coming. Yeah, now you can see that all the state is coming. Now based of that state, I want to display that one city. So how we can do that one? Because once you are going to change, so it's so that page should not refresh. So because that I'm going to use jQuery. So just open that Solution Explorer and go to the script. Drag this one jQuery minimum file. So, and one more thing you can add, that is a parcel view, because I'm going to use that parcel view. So just click on the shared and add view, that select that create parcel view, and then give that name. That will be the city parcel. Click on add. So here it will be the same thing, only not we are going to pass that city. So same thing, it will come here. Let's paste it. Okay, so now we are going to write that jQuery. So script tag, type JavaScript. Now we can write like, so here in the drop down, because in the on change we are going to write, so write here on change event and write here one method name, just like get city. That is a method. So once you are going to change, so get city method will be fire. So write here write into the get city one method, get city. This will be with the function. So write function get city. So $.get. So first we'll going to write here that one action method, that a public action result get city, and that get city is going to pass that state id. So go to here line. So this one also I'm going to change, convert. First I'm going to filter out that one which state ID you want to get the data, and then it will going to convert into select list item. So that I will get that one select list item. List of a select list item. So same way, like from obj in that list of city models, okay, then select new select list item, then what data will we get that value, that obj dot city id, then convert into string. Then next one will be the text. The text will be obj dot city name. That city name. And this one going to convert into to string. Sorry, to list. But one more thing is that if select statement before that, we have to filter out that only that which is will belongs to that particular state, that data should be displayed. So it will become like a where obj dot state id equal to state id. So you can see here that from object, then first then second one is the where condition, only that that particular state data I want to display. So I am putting here that one where clause. After the where clause, that select statement will be here. Now I'm going to return. But one more thing is that here I'm not going to redirect to that view. So that's why I am doing here that I am doing that one parcel view. I want to return that parcel view. So just write a parcel view result and return parcel view. First will be the parcel view name. So what's the name? City parcel. Because just now we have created that one, that city parcel here. So that name will be display here, city parcel. Then next will be that select list item. I am returning here that one parcel view because I don't want to redirect to another page and don't want to refresh the page. So that's why I am returning that parcel view. So here in the parcel view, this one is the parcel view name which I have created in that share folder. That share folder, this one is the parcel view, and this one is the select list item. So we'll go to that index. So here that get method is that home controller. This one will be the home, and second will be the action method name, that is a get city. And second one with the data, in that get one, just data is that state ID. Just now you can see here as a one parameter is that is the state ID. So in the get method, second will be the data, that one will be state ID. So how you will get that one state ID? Because that in the drop down list, that ID is the state. So just use the jQuery. This one name get state dot value, and third one is that result, that is a function. So it will return data. So I'm going to create one div here. So the here actually I want to bind the city is here, that will be the city, and here I'm going to bind that particular your parcel view, means like a city parcel I want to bind here. So div, make the name, that ID will be the city parcel, or any meaningful name you can give here. So I given that city parcel. So and here I want to bind that parcel view dot HTML. So because that data is returning that parcel, so I'm binding the data. Let's check one more time the code. Oh, this one is some wrong here. Because this one parameter is that action name and controller, second will be the data, third one is that function which are going to return. So this one function, this one data is returning, and it will bind here that one. But one more things you can add here. So first time, so the once page is load means document DOM will be loaded, so same times it should be fire that one, that get city. So let's check one more time. So run that application. Now see here, you are displaying that state, but you are not in the based of that curve state, that city is not displaying, and it means that your parcel view is not binding. Once you will change, then you can see that one. If you change, then you can see the data. So while page loading, once DOM is loaded, same time I want to display that city also. How we can do that one? Let's close. Check that once DOM is loaded. So how we can do this? So dollar document dot ready. And call this method one more time. So once DOM will be ready, then this city will be fired. Once DOM is ready, then means state will be load. So once the state will be load, same times that particular this get city method will be fire also. Make a break here, so it's look little bit good. Break here and city, break here. Now run. Now you can see here same times that state is loaded, that's the reference of that is state, that city is loading. Let's see. Now we can see that one, what I have done till now. First we have created that one, that state model and city model. In the state model there is two properties, one is the state ID and state name. Second one is the city model, the city ID, state ID and city name. Next I have created that one, that controller. So that in the controllers constructors, I have created in a slice that one, that data, and added some dummy data. And that action methods, we are returning that select list item, because this one is that list of state model. So I'm converting that list of state model to select list items, and same I'm doing that get city also. Same in the get city also, I'm converting that select list item to that list of select items, or a list of select city item, converting into select of list items. And I'm using that parcel view. So I have created one parcel view here, that is a city parcel. I'm returning that one, that parcel view and that data. I hope it's clear. Thanks for watching.